It's Dr. Mike here again with another medical 3D printing tutorial. You recall in my last tutorial I talked about the new 3D printing service called Imaged on the embodied.com website and how easy it was to convert CT scans to 3D printable bone models. Today I'm going to be expanding on that and showing you how to create multiple bone models simultaneously from a single scan. So we'll talk about how you can use Slicer to create multiple NRRD files, and then how you can upload those multiple NRRD files and have them process simultaneously using the free embodied service. So without further ado, let's fire up Slicer. If you don't have Slicer, you can get it from www.slicer.org. So we'll let Slicer load up, and I'm also going to use the same DICOM data set that I did in my last tutorial. If you would like to download this data set, you can do so by clicking on the link below, which I'll make available, or you can look at my last tutorial, and there's also a link in there. So we're going to drag and drop the DICOM directory onto the Slicer application, and then the DICOM data will load into the database. So while that's going on, what we'll do is we'll take a quick look at slicer.org. If you're not familiar with it, just go to www.slicer.org and you can click on download, and you'll be able to download Slicer in a variety of operating systems. The main thing that we're using Slicer for today is to convert the DICOM data into that NRRD file format. DICOM is usually a scan is represented by dozens and dozens of individual files, and NRRD is a way to store a scan in a single file that makes it easy to upload. And that's the kind of file format that you need in order to use that imaged service on the embodied website. Okay, so looks like Slicer has loaded everything up, so I'm going to open up this study, click load, and here is my study. If you don't have this view, you can use this button to select a variety of different views. This one is called 4UP, but there are several views that you can use, so if you're on a different view, go here and select 4UP. You can use your left mouse button to adjust the window and level. And what we're going to do is, we previously were simply exporting this volume to an NRRD file format, but what I'm going to do is actually create a second volume that is a part of this, only a sub-volume, so that I can 3D print that as well. So if I'm interested in, say, the lumbar spine here, and I want to make another 3D printed model that's only of the lumbar spine, what I can do is use this module called Crop Volume. Now, Slicer has a lot of different modules, and that's one of the things that's, I think, makes it really difficult to use, is that for a beginner, it's overwhelming how many different options you have. So, this is relatively straightforward. Go to Crop Volume, and it will change the tools that you have here. You got to click this little eyelash or eyeball to show the volume, and under this input ROI, say create a new ROI, and this is going to be our ROI cube. So right now it's actually a little too high, so we're going to drag it down, and what you do is you just position it, whoops, try and grab these little control handles and position it where you want over the lumbar spine. Alright, so I'm just going to get this just the way I want it. There are 5 lumbar vertebral vertebrae, and I want to get them all, so 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, so that's one right over there. I don't necessarily want the thoracic. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and in every plane I want to make sure I adjust these walls. So you can see that I'll capture the transverse processes of the lumbar spine. actually can tighten that up just a little bit. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to crop this and make a second 3D printed model that only has this lumbar spine. So once I get that all set up, I click this crop button, and then I have this new volume that only includes the lumbar spine. Okay, now I'm going to save. And you'll be presented with a variety of options, but what you're looking for is these lines that say NRRD. So you want to uncheck everything else. This first line is the actual original scan, which is the entire scan, and this thing that says subvolume scale underscore one, that's the lumbar spine subvolume. You want to specify a directory to save it in, and I'm going to save it in my tutorial directory. And for this other one, I also want to specify the same directory. So both of these files will be saved in NRRD format, which is what we want, into the tutorial directory. So I'm going to click Save. And excuse me, the file should pop up over here. Okay. So here's my lumbar spine, and here's my main scan. So I'm going to go ahead and actually just rename that Tutorial Lumbar Spine. And let's call this Tutorial CT Scan. Okay, now that we have these NRRD files, we're ready to upload them for processing. So we go to the Embodied website at www.embodied.com. And once you get there, click on the Imaged button and Launch App. Make sure you're logged into the website. It won't work if you're not logged in. Then what you do is take both of these files, and they must be NRRD files. It won't work if it's another file format. Take both of these and drag and drop them onto the file upload panel. Okay, and what this is going to do is it's going to process both of the files simultaneously using the parameters that I'm going to enter. Alright, so what should we call this? Let's call this Tutorial Body CT and Lumbar Spine. How does that sound? I'll paste that in the description. We want the uploaded files to be private. I'll specify a license type, although that doesn't really matter too much because the files are private, so it only really matters if they're shared. You have to agree to the terms of use, and we want to turn on imaged processing. The operation is CTNRD to bone STL, so we're going to make a bone STL file. Leave the default threshold. I'll make the quality high. And the privacy of the process files, I can opt to share them publicly. So I'll go ahead and do that. And I'll keep them in the image processing category. I'll make them free. Okay. So once the files have uploaded, and it looks like one of them is the CT scan's uploaded and the lumbar spine's not too large, so that's going to upload. So now I click Submit. Okay, so in about 10 to 15 minutes, these NRRD files will be converted into 3D printable STL files of those areas. The first one is going to be essentially the whole body, or the torso at least, and the second will be the lumbar spine. So let's take a break here and come back in about 10 minutes and see how we're doing at that time. I'll get an email notification when the files are ready. So if you get that notification, you can click on the link provided in the email, or you can of course come back to the Embodied website. Your files should be visible under your profile. Or you can also go to your activity, and actually select files, or if you want, you can go to the download marketplace and select imaged processing, and your files should show up over there. All right, so I'll see you in about 10 or 15 minutes. Hello and welcome back. It's Dr. Mike here again. It's been about 20 minutes, and I got distracted doing something else, so we submitted our file about 20 minutes ago, and about 7 minutes later, our whole body CT model was finished, and I guess about 5 minutes after that, so about 12 minutes, our lumbar spine was ready. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we've got. So here's what our whole body CT scan looks like. This is pretty similar to the last tutorial, so we can go ahead and download that. And let's go back and look at this lumbar spine. Looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and download that one as well. And here's our folder with our two files, and let's take a look at them in Mesh Mixer, which is a free program that allows you to check the quality of your 3D printable files. So here's our body scan. It looks pretty good. If we do an analysis and check to see if there are any errors, there are none. Otherwise, errors are marked in red, so that looks good. Let's look at this lumbar spine and open that one up. And that looks pretty good as well. So that's not bad, considering that it really didn't take us very much time in order to make these. This is 3D printable. Let's double check that for errors, and there are no errors there either. So there we go. Two 3D printable files processed simultaneously off the same scan. And what we did was we created a subvolume in Slicer when we made our NRRD files, and then we submitted both the whole scan and the subvolume to the imaged application for processing, and we were able to process both of them at the same time. They both came back in about 10 minutes or so. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you like it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe. I'll have a number of additional tutorials and videos on how to do medical 3D printing, so be sure to come back. Thanks very much, and happy 3D printing.